Hi, welcome to our masterclass. Today's video is about calcium, also a nutrient element which can cause deficiencies and excesses. If you grow with the right nutrient blend and the right type of nutrient, and of course you give the right dose, in theory it's not possible to get any kind of underfeeding or overfeeding the plant. Nevertheless, a grower can make mistakes, also with calcium. Calcium, although it's a macro element, so quite important, it's not necessary to mention it on the label of a nutrient solution, unless you claim it. Calcium is a very important element for creating the building blocks, the cell walls. But the plant is taking this calcium not only from the nutrient solution, but also from the tap water. Most nutrient brands make their nutrient solution based on normal tap water, which means containing calcium. And if you grow on a terra substrate, actually the plant takes it from the substrate itself, because it contains lime. Calcium is taken in a different way compared to all other nutrient elements. Actually, the calcium is absorbed and by the water transport brought to the place where it's needed. So without any transpiration, no calcium will be taken by the plant. That's why it's so important that in vegetative phase, when the humidity is high, we bring in more calcium by adding a higher amount in the CANNA Vega nutrient. If your climate is high in humidity for a long time, you create actually calcium deficiency. But that also means he will take something else, for example, potassium. Often you will see a potassium excess by a deficiency of calcium. Deficiency of calcium is often shown by brown spots in the old leaves. But don't misunderstand it with magnesium deficiency. It's almost a look-alike because they go together. Magnesium, calcium and potassium are antagonism of each other. That means they compete. That's the reason when we give an overdose of pK 13-14, what you will often see is a deficiency of calcium. An excess of calcium is also possible, mostly created by using very hard water, which contains, of course, a lot of calcium. And that calcium makes the leaf crunchy, very vulnerable. Hard, but vulnerable. And in that case, it's better to make use of a softer water, or you make that water by using a reverse osmosis filter. Calcium, magnesium and potassium, like I said, are antagonism. Because of that, it's hard to see what is the real problem. That's the reason why I also recommend to have a look with the other videos to see the differences.